Hello, neighbors. Hope everybody's hanging in there. I heard recently that we should be careful to not politicize the coronavirus pandemic that we're all living with. But the problem with that is that our response to it is directly affected by political decision making from the past and in the present. And I think we need to follow it. We need to analyze it. We need to pay close attention so that we can learn from any mistakes going forward. Here in Wisconsin, I can't help but think about decisions that have been made over the last decade and more. For example, the Republican refusal to accept the federally available Medicaid expansion has led to the closing of nursing homes, a lack of caregivers, less people having health care in general, the Republican-controlled legislatures strangling of county governments, keeping them strapped through removal of local control and the levy limits, have caused counties to have to cut health and human services and to cut home health care programs and a litany of other public health things that we need right now. And so those are political decisions, and politicizing this has already happened before we even heard of the coronavirus. What are the politicians doing right now? They're politicizing it. I saw on Twitter this weekend, I wrote it out here, the Speaker of the Assembly, Speaker Voss, tweeted this a couple days ago over the weekend. We are social beings. It's why we need to be level-headed. Starts out pretty reasonable. And then he says, let's not allow some to use this situation to grow government, to take away our fundamental liberties as freedom-loving Americans. And so it sounds like classic conservative talk, don't grow government. But it's actually pretty dangerous because Voss and many like him have spent decades telling conservative people and everybody for that matter to be skeptical of government, to be wary of government, to not trust them. And it's dangerous in times like these. And he continues to do this even a couple days ago. And why does he do it? Because he has deeply held conservative beliefs? No, he wants small government because the donors that he works for, the government stands in the way of their profits. And that's the reason that they don't want government. And here we see the ramifications of their demonizing of government in general, is that people don't trust it. I've seen other people online, conservative figures, doubting what government officials are telling us. And it's very dangerous. And why do they do it once again? Just for profits. Because he talks about liberties and freedom, and what he's talking about is the liberty of the companies that he works for to limit wages, to limit benefits, to not offer paid sick leave, and all the things that we're talking about now. And they want the freedom to pollute and the freedom to buy politicians. That's what this is about. And so I hope once this crisis passes, and it will, and it might be months, might be a year, might be more, things are going to be different. But on the other side, I hope that the major takeaway from this in terms of politics is that people realize that for the most part, politicians fall into two categories. People get into politics because they really want to help people, or people get into politics because they really want to help themselves. And I think the most imperative thing for voters to learn is that it's not about the R or the D, whatever letter is following the name of their candidate. Find out if they actually want to help people, because that's the point of government, and that's the point of our representatives. And so I hope we stay safe and try to stay as healthy as we can, listen to the experts, listen to the scientists, and keep paying attention, keep making it political, so that on the other side, we can have a government run by representatives who represent us and actually care about us. And so we'll talk to you again soon. Take care.